So the latest is I can't find my camera accessory, so I got no remote control. I'm just trying to remember where I left off on this. Oh yeah, I did that little finish touch up on the front. I did another little one on the back. I cleaned off, they had left the old paper on this and forever, so it all turned awful, so we cleaned that off. 1084, and there's some sort of serial number here. If I flip this around, make sure I'm in the movie, there's some sort of serial number on there that maybe you guys can see. I don't know, serial number, okay. Let's clean up the bridge. We got to get the strings off it. Clean up the fretboard. Clean up the bridge. Just looking, doesn't look like there's a lot of adjustability in the string height. So I guess
we'll
get it as good
as we can get it.
That would be what we'll get. While I do this, I know everybody sent me a pile of questions to the Canada Guitar Network at Gmail address, and I know that I haven't gotten to them. I'm not going to say that I'm going to get to them soon, because you guys like totally overwhelmed me. I figured, you know, yeah, I'll get like 10 questions. There's like over 200 emails there now. So all we can hope for is that somehow, through the magic of the internet, that I could devote all my time to answering everybody's questions. Now that truly would be the Canada Guitar Network, if we could pull that off. If I could pull that off. But the only way I could pull that off is if I get a lot of support from a lot of other people. So that's sort of what I'm striving for. Don't think that I, you know, blown you off because I didn't answer your question, because I've blown everybody off because there's just too many of them. Oh, look at this is cool here. Let's there, nice. There's dust bunnies hidden in the bridge. Okay, so let's get a rag and clean this up. Gonna zoom. Look at that. A few shots of that. I don't see my toothbrush, but this will get that one in there. Look at that suit. That's just awful. Now I gotta get the air compressor. I'm going to take the tarnish off the frets with a little bit of 1000 grit. A few drops of the linseed oil. Have I ever held that up, the bottle? It's like from an art store. I know I've answered that question a million times. I got really a goofy question today from somebody that wanted to talk about filing these and filing this and going to heavier gauge strings and, oh dude, take that to somebody. And if you really got your heart set on that, find a guitar that's designed with those big heavy strings on it. And, scissors in the nuts. That wasn't good. So there, that's the frets, fretboard. Now I just got to do a little, the final thing. See, look at that though, that's like, final thing. What am I going to do? I'm going to do the old never dull on the frets. Magic wadding. That's way more than I need. It's like a ton. I don't really like too much of the excess liquid. Always remember to put the cap back on your never dull, it'll dry up. And then the magic, the original magic. Magic wadding doesn't, the magic runs out of the jar. Oh lordy. Oh, we gotta figure out what the neck radius is. I did already, but it's like that other Ibanez. It's 7.25. That's about that. This one's toasted. We can't use this rag any longer. Nice. Gonna use a little bit of this stuff. And when I say a little bit, I mean a little bit. That's about enough. Brand new clean rag. Look, but here I am attempting to lower the string action to where I think it should be, and so we've lowered it to the deck. She's to the deck, and well, that's all you get. And let's just see what happens with the other. Let me just measure that, just because we can. Let's just measure. Come here, you crazy thing. What that is at the 12th fret. That's, see, that's higher than I like to see it. I like to see about 70 thou. This is about 90 thou. So, unfortunately, unless we want to get into, my lamp keeps going out of the, let's get it out of that movie there. Unless we want to get into shimming the back of the neck here, that's as low as this one goes. So we're just going to set it up the best we can. If Buddy wants to pay me for some more work, well, I'll be happy to yank the neck off it. Oh, let's just check that radius, see if that's, before I go and wreck everything here. Looks like it was pretty good. In fact, it was... the A string's out. Let's fix best we can. That's all we can do. Measure the G string. It's okay. It's within the realms of reality, but I don't like that E string, and it definitely will not drop down anymore. How about the G string? Is it to the deck as well? Yeah, it appears that it is too, so. Just check the radius again. And it seems to be fine. Well, that's it. That's what I know today. We'll check the intonation, distance from 12th fret to here, and possibly adjust that, or possibly not. And then I guess I'll play it. I haven't really measured the relief yet either, but I'm just sort of, let's just have a look before I get crazy on this. That's as straight as it can be, with no relief, but because the string action's so high, it could be a lot better. Oh well, life in the Ibanez lane. Position. I'm not doing it by ear. I got that thing on the bench. That's what it gets. Ibanez, whatever the numbers are. Roadstar, something series. It's got some cool tuners. That's it. Cool. Cheers, folks. Dun 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 dun.